here's my sanded knife. Getting it ready for tempering now. Hoping this goes well. I'm doing a variable temper. I do believe that that's the way to go. And we'll see how it goes. We got it clamped in a wet rag. Hope it's not too bright out here for me to see what I'm doing, but I think it'll be good. I'm going to try to get the handle area dead soft and put a little spring in the back, get that to a blue, and get some straw down the sides of the blade and have it stop short of the actual cutting edge. Starting to turn blue back here. That should be good. I'm gonna get this almost a red. Got it turning gray now, so should be pretty close. close now. Getting that blue down into there. I don't want to get that blue any closer down there. Rag is sucking heat right out of it. Which I guess is what you want. Alright. Let's try letting that cool off and moving it. And there we go. Let's try heating up the other side. I'm going to let this one cool off and then try some map gas and see if it heats it up a little better. But it's doing an okay job. See how it goes. And now I'm going to try it with the map gas and see how that works. If it's any better or not. Let it preheat a little bit the whole length so you don't stress out any one part of the blade. This is my third time through. And I can thank Evan for one of his videos helping instructing on how to do this. Artist Blade, 1972. That's his channel. And I want to thank Pinto for inspiring me to continue to do this. Because watching his videos has definitely given me the itch. It's about 85 out here. Nice and hot. That's why I decided to do it outside. Figured it was a nice day for doing it. Well, this stuff definitely burns hotter. Never really used map gas much. I always had oxygen acetylene torches, never had a need for it, but I can see it's good for this. Oh yeah. Definitely getting it way hotter, way quicker. Getting nice and glowing now.